Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. You're joining me inside the iniBuilds Airbus A350, and in this video we're going to look at the climb. We're currently being cleared up to our cruise at 35,000 feet, and we're about to pass 10,000 feet. So once we reach 10,000 feet, there's a little flow we conduct. There we go, 10,000 feet. So our landing lights can come off. We can take the seatbelts off now if conditions are suitable and our pitch is not too high. They come off, release the cabin. We want to set our QNH to standard and cross-check, so Captain, First Officer and ISIS display down here is all in standard, and we want to cross-check the altitude that we're passing. So passing 10.4 now, that's cross-checked. Then we want to set up our EFIS, so we want to consider whether we still need weather radar or terrain radar. Zoom out, for example. Make sure we've got other airports on in case we need to divert anywhere, that kind of thing. So just to ensure we're displaying sensible information pertinent to this stage of flight. As the aircraft accelerates, it's always a good idea to look further ahead, so it allows us to plan ahead, essentially. Do a check of the ECAM memo. There's no messages there, no warnings there to be concerned with at the moment. Then we want to come down to the FMS. We'll select nav aid here, and we would clear out any manually tuned nav aids that we may have put in there for the departure. We haven't used that today, so nothing to clear, but that's where we do that. All you have to do is click on them and delete. Then we want to come to the performance page. We want to take a look at our optimum flight level and our maximum flight level, make sure that we can reach our target cruise altitude there as well. Down here you've got the time prediction, when we will reach flight level 350 and the distance that will take. We can check out other altitudes here as well, so it's literally a case of typing in other flight levels and it will show you prediction for those too, which is handy. Then we want to do the after takeoff checklist below the line, and we've checked our barrows. Have that checklist complete. And put that down to back down to performance. As we're climbing, we may enter icing conditions. So if the TAT temperature is below 10 degrees and the SAT temperature is above 40 degrees, and with invisible moisture, so clouds, we'll need to turn on engine anti-ice. If the systems detect icing, give us a warning, or we see any visible moisture on the aircraft accumulating and some of the surfaces. There is a probe out here as well, just that's the kind of place you'll see ice forming. It's a good idea to keep an eye on that. We've got lovely conditions today, however it's not always the case. So in that case you'd use engine 1 and 2 anti-ice, or if you've got visible icing forming on the aircraft, use the wing anti-ice, for as long as those conditions remain. So we're currently following our vertical and lateral profile in manage mode. So we've got climb instructed. If ever you're on your departure and you're told immediately to climb by air traffic control and disregard any restrictions, that's when you would use open climb. So using open climb would disregard restrictions and it will take you up to your cleared altitude. Put that back into manage climb. It's always a good idea to show at least the next waypoint on your navigation display. Just notice we also would want to clear out the line we put in for our engine out track on the fixed info page for London Heathrow there. So we've come down, we'll go to the flight plan, select flight plan info, select fixed info, and we can simply delete that out. Back to the performance page. That line's now gone. Things you want to keep an eye on as well is making sure that the cabin altitude is pressurizing, so I've got an increase here. It's under control. And also keeping an eye on engine performance as we climb out. Take a scan of the panel, making sure there's no warnings or lights to be concerned about. And at the pedestal too. That's all looking good. So, those are the climb checks in the Airbus A350. If you have any questions on that, please drop them in the comments, and don't forget to hit like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. Thanks for watching.